Give me a ticket for an aeroplane. Ain't got time to take a fast train. Lonely days are gone, I'm a-going home. My baby just wrote me a letter. I don't care how much money I gotta spend.
Badger Bites, this is Gene 40. Our story begins June 6, 2010. My wife and I and family go out and spread about 10,000 flyers telling of the Merced County Grand Jury complaint we have against the Los Banos Police Department and the Merced County District Attorney's Office. We're saying that they're covering up that Mayor Tommy Jones influenced a high school student of his, Anthony Donaldson Bates, to send me death threats. They have their own reasons for covering it up. But the day after we put out these flyers, I have a phone call from Special Agent Luke Pella of a California Department of Justice. Listen to this call. And along the way, I'll jump in once in a while and maybe pose some questions that you ought to think about. See ya.
Hey, Eugene. My name is Special Agent Luke Pella. I work for the California Department of Justice. I don't know if I have the right Eugene Forte or not, but I was out at 688 Birch Court in Los Banos last night. If this is your address, could you give me a call back? You're not in any trouble by any means, but if you can give me a call back, I would appreciate it.
Isn't it curious that a Department of Justice special agent would come out and basically stake out your house, but not know if you're the right person or not?
Hello?
Well, I'm glad to see I'm not in any trouble, thank God.
Is this Eugene?
This is Gene 40 calling.
Yes. Hey.
Hi, Lou. How are you doing?
Good. Hey, this is just a long shot. I don't even know if I have the right Eugene or not. I just found this phone number on the internet, so that's why I'm calling it.
He found my name on the internet? Stakes out my house?
Let's see. Do you live at 688 Birch Court?
Yes, I do.
Okay. This is the person I'm trying to get a hold of, and you are not in trouble.
Good. I'm trying to stop some people that I think should be in trouble.
Okay. Well, the reason why I'm calling you is because I work for the state, and we maintain the automated firearm system.
Mm-hmm.
Well, somebody put an input error at some point in time in the computer system,
mm-hmm.
and you, at one point in time, were the owner of American Industries, or a Calico.
Yes.
9mm pistol?
Yes.
Somebody put in the serial number starting with an R, and then someone else put it in as starting with a B.
Okay.
So I just need to clarify if it's an R or B, and then I also show that it was taken into safekeeping.
That's correct.
Could you tell me which agency took it into safekeeping?
The Los Banos Police Department.
How could a special agent know the serial number of a gun? No, but somehow there's some type of mistake made on it being logged in. No, but it was taken in, but not know where it was taken in. Now that just doesn't make sense. Does it?
Okay. Do you have it was taken in this year.
Yes.
Okay. Los Banos. Okay. All right, and you are not in possession of any other firearms?
No.
Okay. Very good.
Agent Pella asked me if I have any other guns. What, like I'm hiding guns? Come on.
You wouldn't have to remember a case number or anything like that.
Yeah, in fact, hold on one second.
Okay.
What I was really hoping you're calling for, Lou, you know, we put out, 15,000 flyers yesterday and the day before regarding, look at, I received death threats from a student of the mayor of Los Banos.
Okay.
The mayor of Los Banos, I'm a writer. I had the Badger Flats Gazette. Mm-hmm. I exposed the mayor for taking loans under the table from a Greg Hostetler. The FPPC found him guilty in January. In February, we received death threats from a high school student of his. It's a regular Cold Stone 422.
Okay.
The police investigated in 15 minutes. The kid confesses to doing it, and the police don't ask any questions of the mayor, They don't ask the kid if he talked to the mayor about it. The mayor is the one that did this. We have all the evidence to prove it. We are sitting on top of corruption here in Los Banos that I've exposed that has endangered my family. The reason why that gun was turned in, because the mayor went out and got a TRO against me. All right?
Okay.
This is way beyond, Lou, what anybody could imagine. We have the evidence to prove it. I'm not a criminal in any way, shape, or form.
Yes.
But I'm a writer that went ahead and exposed these guys. So
okay.
That's why I was hoping you came. I mean... That's why I was hoping you would contact me, but instead somebody's gone ahead and asked you to verify if all my weapons have gone ahead and been turned in.
Yeah.
I tell a law enforcement agent that I have had death threats made against me by a mayor of Los Banos that's covered up by the police department. I get no response from him. I actually get a nervous laugh. What is that? And I find out now why he called me was to see if I had any more guns. Who's he working for?
Well, what you're talking about was something that goes through our office. Any kind of political corruption would go through the Attorney General's office.
The Attorney General is... Oh, excuse me, I'm sorry. Go ahead.
Yeah, the State Attorney General's office. Unfortunately, I don't work in that bureau for the State Attorney General. I work for the Bureau of Firearms. So you're talking about something that's just out of my realm.
Well, I understand.
So a California Department of Justice agent, Luke Pella, contacts me the day after I put out about 15,000 flyers, publicized the Merced County Grand Jury complaint against the Los Banos Police Department and the Merced County District Attorney's Office. The complaint basically alleges that I received death threats from Mayor Tommy Jones through a student that he had at Los Banos High School, and the Los Banos Police Department is covering it up. Was it coincidence that Luke Pella contacted me? Do you really believe that Luke Pella did not know the gun was taken in by the Los Banos Police Department? Do you really believe that he didn't know the serial number on that gun already? Why didn't he contact the police department? What is this Luke Pella up to? Why would a special agent of the Department of Justice resort to looking for my name and my telephone number on the internet? He had all that information. Supposedly for Los Banos Police Department. Something doesn't smell right now, does it? It's a trap that blew back in their faces. This is Gene 40. We'll see you later. Catch another Badger Bite.
Give me a ticket for an aeroplane. Ain't got time to take a fast train. Lonely days are gone. I'm a going home. My baby just wrote me a letter. I don't care how much money I gotta spend. Got to get back to my baby again. Lonely days are gone, I'm a going home. My baby just wrote me a letter. When she wrote me a letter, said she couldn't.